the 80s, me and Pops would rap. In a 7-0 Chevy with the drops and slap. Used to pass me Pepsi Cola while they drunk in my pipe. Tipping through the south side, running a light. Used to have me up in Third Ward, checking his tracks, collecting his scratch, protecting his snacks. Used to always tell a nigga, keep your mind on paper. Bitches in your ear, you keep your eyes on paper. Cause a nigga's definition is a killer for scratch. You kill a motherfucker, you kill him for that. You got caught up in the shit that meant you fucked it up. Old man was in game, so I sucked it up. Old enough to do my own thing, got me a gig. Flipped my second paycheck to cop me a lick. Went and seen my homie Show Dog to slide me a track. Went to Mason's pawn shop, got me a cat. Didn't know this crack shit, I got my uncle to cook. With my eyes on my paper, I just fumbled and looked. Impatiently waiting for the pop, boy. Man, I can't wait to see you rock from boy. Put my work up on the table, and it's starting tonight. Time for me to bring Brad Jordan to life. Set my ass up on the corner till it started to bounce. Clock scratching, restacked, and started to out. It wasn't long before I was going for nine. I'm 17 around millionaires going for mine. And if you got off in my way, well, I was headed for that. They found your ass misplaced with your head in your lap. And niggas is getting shifer with time. That's why you never seen me with a partner in crime. I'm down and dirty, nigga, fuck the world. And that's what separated the ghetto boys and girls, come on.
Fifth Ward is a spot where niggas get shot. Wholesale cock and every block is hot. Niggas start shit but they don't start it with Bill. Cause some motherfuckers know that blood gon' spill. Ever since I was a kid growing up in the bottom, I beat a nigga's ass if I did not shot him. Never gave a fuck about his family crime. Bottom line, better his than mine. You come around me with that live shit, I kill it fast. I throw a search party for your fucking stinking ass, nigga. Cause it's a motherfucking rep thing. You got a set of nuts, you better let the motherfuckers hang. Even if you fits in 20 years, you never rat. You do your time and you come on back. And if your homie really take care of your people while you're gone, and bless you when you come back home. Do your time and don't whine is the motherfucking anthem. That's the type of shit most niggas can't fathom. Them bitches' tongues come unfurled. But that's what separates the ghetto boys from girls. Come on.
I bet you often wonder how niggas survived in the trap. You got jacked and took six and died in your house. And motherfuckers sat and grieved your death. While other motherfuckers counted up the keys. Kinda strange how they game and took the change. Split the brain, get the cane, and get back to your turf. And keep the jack you did up under your hat. Cause if the word get out, you kill them, then they killing you back. I never thought that 86 would bring me trouble. But these niggas on some up shit like double your pay. And gives a fuck about respect and joke. So how you figure niggas got respect for hoes? But then again, niggas always put their trust in this bitch. But in the end, it's another nigga busting your shit. Fucked around and had to leave the world. Cause you couldn't separate the ghetto boys from girls. Ghetto boys is the motherfucking shit. Never forget them southern niggas made your mind play tricks. Nevertheless, I left the group in 91. Niggas was mad. I had my gun.
they had their guns too. I wasn't snoozing, cause I knew that if it came down to it, they were using. If it was going down like them, I didn't give a fuck. We was gonna tear this whole motherfucking city up. And nigga, that's real, coming from the south. You whack-ass rappers, watch your motherfucking mouth. Preaching that positive bullshit that you can save, cause your positivity ain't getting motherfuckers paid. It's GB and Willie D reunited, sending niggas back to the studio to get they shit tighter. And niggas thought it wouldn't happen again, but we sat down and settled our differences like men and put the bullshit behind us. Cause fucking off money ain't a plus, it's a minus. We did what other niggas too big to do when they twirl and separated ghetto boys from girls. Come on.
AJ, you know, I spent 23 years in the prison. You know, I'm still in prison. You know, they renounced us blacks. We represent 37% of the prison system throughout the country. 37%. And we don't represent for 12% of the country. Now, that's disproportionate. And it ain't no joke. You know, it's not by coincidence or happenstance. It's by design. By the year 2015, they're going to have 70% of our community locked up. I'm talking about blacks going to be locked up within their